What do we got? I call this the Brian Wilson bass guitar. Beach Boys seem to have white P basses. Anyhow, it's a Made in Mexico 96, I think is what that says. Which, I had one of these guys. Somewhere I have a picture of me playing it in the studio somewhere. Anyway, brought to me by a friend of mine. A union brother and work buddy, Richard. So we're going to make it square. The neck was really bent, and I actually went ahead and did a little bit of straightening yesterday just because I was getting scared because it was really bent. But I'll go through what I did and how I did it. And I'm going to go through the whole setup. We'll make this thing play. It's got some nice flat ones on it, too. So here's what happened. I will replicate. Oh, look, a battery on the floor.
How'd that happen?
Oh, I need a climbing lamp. So sometimes when especially with the bass, if you don't, you know, tweak the truss rod every once in a while, they can get really bent, right? And when it's really, really bent, it's very difficult to depend on the truss rod to actually pull this big, huge chunk of maple where it needs to be. I'm just looking for the wrench I was playing with yesterday. Is this it? Let's see. Could it be true? That's the guy. So, I'm not going to do it because I already straightened it out. But what I would do, what I did do, you can get a family member to help. Somebody just got to hold the end of the bass guitar down so it doesn't jump up on you. But I clamp to bench with soft clamp so it doesn't rise up. And that's when we get to another use for these guys. So at that point, I placed that guy about there and the bass was clamped down here. All the strings were loose, right? And then what you do is push down on the headstock, and you can see I can even get it to get quite a bit of flex out of that. Flex the neck, then turn the truss rod to hold that position. And I just want to double check that yesterday's cranking did what it was supposed to do. So at that point, capo down here, first fret, pushing down on the 17th, 12 thou feely gauge at the 7th fret, right? And that should just, like I said, it's a feeler gauge. You can just feel it touching like a feather. So that's absolutely great. But that brings me to the next screw up on this thing. This was a pretty good find. It was a pawn shop find, $150. But she'd never work right. I'll show you why.
So what's going on is when we pull the bridge saddle adjustment screws all the way out, the E-string is just barely where I'd like to see it. And so what I'd really like to do is have a tiny bit of adjustability in both directions and not have these big screws sticking out to rip your hands open on. So I was taking the strings off it anyway to clean up the fingerboard and give the frets a little cleanup. So we're just going to put a little shim in the back of the neck pocket, and then we'll have some room to jiggle up and down.
Someone did ask me, you know, how do you figure out when you shim a neck, how do you figure out what the neck angle should be? Well, one way to do that is take a bridge saddle. I'll get that string out of the way anyway because I'm going to take the bar. You can do it, Davey. You can do it. Excuse me. I'll take your straight edge. If you continue across the fingerboard that guy should just crest, should line up, right? So that's what I want to get. I've done this so many times. It's going to be about 10 thousandths of an inch here to bring it up. Not quite 20 thousandths here, but it'll be great. You'll see. Today's shim will be a piece of hardwood veneer, which is very consistent in thickness. And you can sand it down a little bit if you want. I'm going to roll at this. It's about 26 thou. It might be a little thick, but, you know. And it might not be a little thick. I've got to trim the edges of that so it fits back where it needs to go. I hear noises upstairs. Is there life? There, I like that. Get rid of these crumbs. Let's put it back together. So I cleaned the fingerboard with Simple Green. And now it's getting a good lashing with my favorite linseed oil. And as you see, we just wipe it in and wipe it off. Don't leave it on. Don't let it dry. Don't do this. This is like once a year, maybe, if it needs it. Depends where you live. Right? I'm not marinating a frickin' piece of meat. There. Now let's clean up the frets a bit. Today's fret cleaning is brought to you by Fret Eraser. Can't remember where I got these. I think they came from my friends at Philadelphia Luthier. And there's two grits. Time to clean these up a bit on the belt sander. Nice. Then we'll go with the pink. Pink! Sink the pink. Everybody having a good time? So where are we? We straightened out the neck. We've cleaned and oiled fingerboard. We got all the shite off the frets, right? Let's reinstall the neck with my little shim that's in there, and everything should rock at that point. It should be straight ahead, straight ahead. So you can see now that the bridge saddle is up. The string height is set, and the screws aren't sticking out to bite you in the hand. And now I've got some room to go up and down. Cool, huh? So let's set all the other strings. I like to see 5/64. That's from the bottom of the string to the top of the fret, and that's consistent all the way across. And the strings match the radius of the fingerboard. What a concept. Okay, let me get that going. Well, a little scratchy. Pull some cleaner down in those from the top. I'm not taking the... Actually, see what happens. It's lack of use. But I am going to drop some cleaner down in those. Where was I? Oh, string height set. Let's tune it. Tune it up the bitch. Relief again because I had the strings popped off it for a minute. Mm-hmm. it.
Don't need to listen to that.
We don't need to listen to the neck relief. This I do know. Right? Capo's down there at this end. 17th fret, 7th fret. Look at that. That just sneaks in there beautifully. I'm so happy it's straightened out. I hate when I get these things and they're all bent and you just go, well, I'll try. And then once again, now that I've got my string height, you can see that the saddles are up a nice distance and there's a good break angle where the strings come over them. That's the other problem, when you have to dunk the saddle all the way to the bottom to get it right, then the string doesn't really crest over there and it's not a good solid contact point. Alrighty, what else could go wrong? Oh, the intonation for Starvation. And some pickup height. I want to double check this one more time here. Why does that look like it's all high now? Because it is. What happened? Oh, as soon as I tuned it up to pitch. I see. Okay, well, we're just going to drop things down a little bit and we'll all be good. Yeah. Wind up the old Peterson tuner. What other silly questions did someone ask? Oh, when's the last time you had the Peterson calibrated? They don't need to be calibrated. It's a crystal. It's a tuned quartz crystal in there. There's nothing to calibrate. And laying down position. Anyway, yeah, so it's like tune the string to pitch, hit the harmonic, make sure it's tuned to pitch, then fret the note. According to the Peterson, everything's a tiny bit sharp so far. Pickup height. There's always controversy about the angled pickup setup. I have never encountered any difference between the pickups being straight across or at a slight angle. Ever. But hey, who knew? Yeah, so I think I'm pretty close to quitting this kind. Thank you.
spray those guys out. Let's do that, and then we'll quit.
Somebody made me these attachments, which are super cool. A little shot of deoxit down the hole. Give that a minute to seep down through the and around the shaft of the pot itself. And I did have to release this here, a little bit of gooch. But anyway, it's easier than pulling the whole pick guard. I hate to say it, but it is. Put that guy back on there. It's all good. Wow. How'd we do? Time. Don't make me, really? This, why not? So what do we end up with? A made in Mexico back in the 90s guy based P based thing. Thanks for hanging out with me, folks, as always. Remember, I still have Dave's World of Fun Stuff stickers, lots of them. There's still a handful of guitar picks left. I have one here to show you. Look, see on one side it says Intonation for the Nation on the other side. Still got a bunch of those. Thanks to all my patrons again, as always. You guys do completely rock my world and make a lot of this possible. Right? I like this. Till next time, folks, down below the links to the Patreon and stickers and Facebook group. Thanks, the Facebook group's rocking. It's a lot of laughs. It's a little more interactive than the stupid YouTube comments. And with that in mind, till next time, cheers. Stay happy.